Now that we've created a PayPal developer account and we have a PayPal sandbox site, we can configure the PayPal account details for testing. We'll be using PayPal as a way for customers to pay for access to the membership site. If the PayPal options are not set, then the PayPal buttons we generate for the membership options page will not function properly. We'll get a warning banner at the top of the screen if these settings have not been configured. If you've not already done so, log into your PayPal developer account. We now need to get the information for the S2 member PayPal setup. Open a new tab and log into your WordPress site and navigate to the S2 member's PayPal options and click the PayPal account details bar to open the screen. The information we need for this screen is obtained from the Sandbox Test site. Keep this open so we can switch back and forth to enter the details. Switch tabs to the developer account. We need to log into the Sandbox Test site to get the merchant ID. For that, we'll need the business email address from the developer account, which is the email with the dash facilitator, and the password for that email. Click on the Enter Sandbox site under the Sandbox Test Account screen, which takes you to the PayPal Sandbox site. Enter the business email address and the business password to log in. The information we need is located under the profile link. We need the merchant account ID, which is on the My Business Info screen. Copy the merchant ID, switch tabs to the S2 member PayPal options screen, and paste the merchant ID in the field. Next, we need the email address, which is also located on the My Business Info screen. Copy the email and switch tabs and paste the email address in the corresponding S2 member field. Next, we need the API information. This is on the My Sellings Tool screen. Click the My Sellings Tool link and locate the API access and click Update. If this is the first time setting up API permissions, you'll need to click the View API Signature under Option 2. Now, from the View or Remove API Signature screen, copy the API username and switch tabs to the S2 member PayPal screen and paste that in the corresponding field. Now, do the same for the API password, and finally the signature. Now, make sure the developer/sandbox testing button is selected to Yes, Enable. Also, the Enable logging routines can be set to Yes to help with any debugging during testing. These log files can be viewed by clicking this Log Viewer link. But remember to turn both of these off before going live for security. Now click the Save All Changes button at the bottom of the screen. Now any transactions that you perform will use the Sandbox Test site and are not live transactions. Now when we create the PayPal buttons later, we can test transactions and work out any problems before going live. When we go live, we'll need to change this information to the active PayPal account details and make sure the developer sandbox testing selection is set to no and the enable logging routine is set to no. This will allow S2 member to communicate with a live PayPal account. And remember to click the Save All Changes button to activate any changes.